Hey guys, this is Sajan Patel here and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be reviewing the new build which is out for Microsoft Windows 10. So let's just go into the build and see what do we have there. So let me just quickly unlock my device. By the way, if you are not familiar with the device I'm using, it's a Lumia 950XL, the white version. I have it here, so you know, this is my start screen. You know, I don't like to usually, you know, modify those screen in a very, in a beautiful way, but you know, I just like to have a good amount of details, you know, just in a single page. So I will just jump to the settings here and see which build are we running. So it is 14977.1000. I hope you can see that here clearly. Okay, yeah, there we go. So my Mi 5, it's not good in recording this, you know, video, so bear with me. Okay, so let's just jump into the you know, messaging, where I have a friend named Tay Toriaki on YouTube, and he just had a lot of problems with his messaging app. I don't know what's the problem, but buddy, in my Windows phone, as you can see, it's just working as fine as, you know, the regular usage. So I'll quickly open something, and you see, I can just use my messaging everywhere, anywhere, you know, probably, and it's not crashing at all. And you know, I was just the other day when the build was released, I was, you know, seeing a lot of people having, you know, trouble installing this build, but you know, with me there has been no such kind of problems. As you can see, this you know, build has, you know, a lot of installation problem. A lot of people have commented over here, but you know, for me there is no such case. Okay, so yeah, well, there are a few bugs here and there. Apart from those bugs, you know, I will be sharing few of the hurdles which I'm having using this build. Okay, so you know, if you just go into this build, you know, these are the change logs for this particular build, and you know, there are a lot of changes related to, you know, Microsoft Edge. And you know, now the good thing is, you know, third-party apps can break into the, you know, quiet hours, which is really good for some apps like ReAlarm, which is one of the best app on the Windows Store. And another thing is, you know, now they have some, you know, notification priority going on for alarms, and you know, some authentication support has been increased for Yahoo mails. You know, should not be a problem while fetching those emails from the server now. And they also fixed, you know, some music apps which were, you know, forced closing after, you know, just like you know, after finishing the call, or you know, getting onto a call. Also, they fixed the issue where if you are using a Bluetooth headset and you are getting the call and it was getting disconnected. Okay, so now we don't have those kind of issues. And they also have fixed something related to the start screen apps, you know, getting reloaded every time. Not every time, but you know, reloaded after, let's say, playing heavy games or something. You see those loading screens coming up here and there, and you know, that's all resolved for now. Let me just jump back again. And also, you know, yeah, that's it, you know. And some devices, you know, which Microsoft claims, you know, devices like 550 and 650 or maybe 640XL, which are just 1 gig RAM of phones, you know, they are having trouble installing this build. But you know, with my 950XL, I did not had any issues. So you know, these are some stuffs, you know, I will just quickly share one of them. This is Microsoft Edge, okay, as you can see. And the issue was before, you know, if I am opening another tab and if I am just closing that tab, you know, the whole Microsoft Edge was getting closed. So the you know, that issue has been fixed now, and we don't have any such kind of problems. Okay, so you know, there are still some problem while adding the languages. Okay, but you know, Cortana has never been before. better to me. Okay, so what happened, you know, few days before the moment when I started using Cortana, you know, I did had some problem, just like, you know, because I'm in India, and when I want to use my Cortana, I need to change the region here. So if I just go to time and language and just select my region, I had to select it United States or maybe UK or maybe you know, some another country where Cortana is supported, but in India it is not yet supported, or maybe even if it's then it is in beta version. Okay, so I'm not pretty much familiar with that. So earlier I had you know, it's setting to US, and the issue was, so let's just say I am just you know, going to Cortana and jumping into the settings. Okay, so it still do not let me select try to respond only to me. Okay, all right, so it's working now. It was not working before, so there might be some just rebooting issues or something like that. Okay, so other thing was, if I just see, yes, here you see Cortana languages. So here are few languages which I can select, which is UK, US, or maybe Canadian or Australian English. But right now, I before I used to have English US, and when I just say the phrase "Hey Cortana," as you can see on the screen, it just popped out right now. But before, I was not getting all these things, so I just turned the setting back, you know, just try changing the region to India, and it's completely working now. And as you can see, it is, you know, let me just focus here, it is, you know, detecting whatever I just said. I know it might not able to answer though, because that's a really long phrase. So, you know, it works. So let me just you know, give you a demo. Hey Cortana, what's on my calendar tomorrow?
You've got one event tomorrow at 10:49 p.m. Animation returns.
Well, that's just my boss coming back to the office. So, you know, that's okay. And another thing is, you know, there are few issues where I have been, you know, I'm running into few issues, like in Outlook. Okay, the mailbox, you know, I do have syncing problem, you know, but it's not as bad, you know. So what I have to do is, you know, just go to my Outlook, and you know, sometimes I need to refresh it manually to fetch those emails, but that's just only with Microsoft Outlook, which means, you know, Outlook emails, and not with my Gmail. Okay, so I do not have any problem here with my Gmail. So it works fantastically fine. It's very smooth. The only thing I have, the problem here is, you know, when I'm opening, sometimes, you know, when I'm opening an XL, you know, apps, or maybe an Excel file from the email itself, you know, the Excel app gets crashed. Okay, that's the issue which I'm having sometimes, not every time. Okay, and the another issues which I you know, ran out was a scrolling issue. So let's just say if I'm just opening let's say this email here, and okay, so it gets loaded, and now I'm just, you know, zooming in a little bit, and as you, if you can see if I'm scrolling it, you might see, you know, a lot of glitches coming here and there. So I would like, you know, Microsoft to fix this kind of issues, you know, like this is usually screen flickering or something, which is not good, you know, like using a $600 device and still having issues like this. It's not just worth it, you know. So I think you need to fix that. And another thing is, you know, getting a notification sound while you are getting an email. So this is the issue which I'm running since a long time. I think this was not present in Windows 8.1, but since I'm on Windows 10, I just cannot figure out how to get those sounds, you know, while getting the email. I already have some sound changes here. So if I just go to my personalization, I go to sounds here, and if I see manage sounds for each and every app. Okay, so here is my Outlook mail, and I do have the notifications on. You see here. So I still don't know. There is also a notification sound set. It's not to none. It is default, but I still do not get any notification voice. So I would like Microsoft to fix that. And another issue my friend was having on his 640XL is when he turns his notification shades down, it always shows him, you know, no notification, rather than showing up something which is, you know, like any notification he has, okay? And another thing, issue he was having is with the brightness toggle, okay? So the first thing, it is suggested here, okay? So let's see. It is getting brighter, okay? It is getting brightest, so yeah, it just, you know, raised it price, you know, brightness. I'm going into darkest, which is the most, you know, the darkest level the screen can go, and this is darker, so little bit bright over to the darkest. So it just works for me. There are no problem, and I have not resetted the device, you know, anytime, you know. So this is the build where I think I resetted it 5 to 6 times, you know, before updating 5 to 6 times to this, you know, build, but not recently, not in at least, you know, 3 to 4 months, I have not resetted the device at all. So let me just you know, turn it back to suggested. Yeah, and another issue which I have on YouTube playback, okay, which is related to rotation lock, okay? So as you see, you know, the rotation is locked as of now. So if I just go to my tube, which in case is working very fine, before it was not working. Oh my god, what do I'm seeing? UK just spawned, just locked this website, not a problem. Okay, so there is one of the video I'm just opening here. It's not mine, first of all. So if I just play here, okay, and it is, let me just, my internet it's not that good, so you might face some issues. So if I just rotate, it just works fine. I mean, like, the rotation is off, it should not work, right? But still, I don't know what is the problem or something, it still gets rotated. I tried checking it into the settings. There are no settings built into, at least in this app or in another app which I'm using, which is PerfectTube. There are no, you know, there are no settings to lock the rotation or something. So I don't know what's the issue over here. This is the issue which I'm facing since last build. Okay, last build also had this issue. And apart from that, if I just jump into my file explorer here, you know, open this Word document, okay? Okay, so this is one of the project that one of my students are doing. So when I just try to scroll here, you can see, you know, it takes, you know, the scrolling is not smooth at all. You know, I would not see, even if, you know, zooming, pinching in and pinching out, it is not smooth. You know, definitely there are, you know, drops in the frame rate, which is again not a good thing. Well, because, you know, I know, you know, this is a you know, a beta version, but still, this is a fully fledged device, right? This is not a cheap or a mediocre device. This is a high-end smartphone, so it should not happen. You know, problems like this should not happen. And yeah, other than that, you know, I do have a couple of issues while downloading apps from place, you know, Windows 2. The thing is, when I just, you know, browsing to the store is not a problem to me at all. It works really fine. It is very fast. Okay, the problem comes when I am just trying to download a app. Okay, sometimes the app just doesn't work. I mean, it works, but then, you know, the downloading takes a good amount of time. You know, I don't even get speeds. maybe it's just a Microsoft server problem, or I don't know what's wrong. But as you can see, you know, starting download, it takes, I mean, like really long time. Yeah, I do a 6 Mbps internet. That is not low, you know, that's not, you cannot count it as a, you know, low speed internet. But still, you know, downloading it, you know, takes some time. Okay, see, definitely I usually get, you know, up to 1 Mbps, you know, 1 megabytes of downloading speed while downloading content, but the speeds are very less. Okay, the speeds are very very less. And another thing which I would like to figure out here is, if you don't want to run into problems, or if you just do not want to reset, okay, just simply go to the setting and go to storage here. Yeah, so see, these are my settings for all the apps to get installed, or all the musics to get downloaded. Okay, so I always install my apps, even games, just because I do have more space on my internal internal memory. I save all the apps to my device, and rest other than that, I save everything to my SD card, you know, which gives me no problem, you know, while recovering those apps when you are restoring, or maybe, you know, upgrading to a new faster build. Okay, so it should not be a problem. So guys, you know, that's it for this particular video. Thank you for watching it. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it and give it a thumbs up, and you know, stay updated to the future videos which I am gonna upload with each and every update of Fast Ring Insider Build. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out.